Today I want to demonstrate the workflow to create a loft or B-spline surface. I start with three curves. In this case we have three sketches. The copy of one master sketch, this one here in the middle. And now I want to create first a loft. That means I make reference objects of the three sketches, these three refs, and the middle sketch I use a reduced curve object, and I display it in the 3D scene. So we see here the reduced curve object, and we can now modify it as usual. Sometimes I have a bit trouble with my monitors and with my mouse. Okay, we can modify it. That means I have here the center of mass mode, and I can now make the segment larger, and I can move the control point a little bit. Okay, and now we have a look at the workflow. In the workflow, I have here an if else node, and from here the calculation can switch first to this branch, and in this branch, in the upper branch, I have here a list of shapes. I combine three curves and I create a loft, and I create the grid of the loft, and it works if the if flag of this is set. So I set it, and in this case we see here the calculation. I can once more calculate it. We see here the flow, and I get at the end the loft, the grid of the loft, and we see this grid here in this structure. So I hide the sketches. We only see now the modification of the first sketch. This is the red curve, and the original first sketch was the yellow curve. And when I change something in the reduced curve, we see how the loft is updated. So this is very fast. Okay, and now the next way is if I switch here the if else node, the workflow goes this way. I have on the other side here a B-spline surface which chooses a list of vector lists. These are the poles, and there are first a connection from the first sketch. The second one is a list of poles I get from the third sketch. And then I get here the reduced curve. And in one branch, the data go into the list of vector lists. And I also have two helper points arrays where I use this data, and here I have a move vector, and I move one rep 100 units up, and here is the other one, I move it 100 reps down, and so I have five reps to create the B-spline surface, and now I can execute it, and I see the result. So let now hide the loft grid and display the B-spline surface grid, this one. So, and now I have to change the flag of the if-else switch, and we see here the result, it is recomputed. Okay, I can do the same as for the loft. I can change here the parameters to get the B-spline surface changed. At the end, we have a look here at the presentation of the B-spline surface as full face with this Vue 3D node. When I go here, I can look at the calculation time. So I clear, and now I run the Vue 3D of the B-spline. And now it takes a little bit more time to get a face. We need in this case nearly 8 seconds. And we can do the same for the surface of the loft. Here we have the loft, you have the view object for the loft. And I run it too. And in this case, I need 13 seconds to create this surface. And at the end, we can have a look on the surfaces. So the first thing what I do is I hide the reduced curve display here. The next what I do is I hide the grids of the loft and the B-spline and the reduce curve. So, okay, this now is the loft created by these curves. And we see the structure of it. We have this one. And we switch to the B-spline, the generated B-spline. And in this case, I have this structure. Here I have 5 times 80 poles because the starting sketch has 80 poles. The loft has another complexity. Here we have 3 times 156 poles. It's a completely different structure and another layout. The benefit of the B-spline is that I can influence all these helper curves, and here in the loft I have the problem that a method something calculates and I can accept it or not.